Thank you, Madam Speaker. And I recall back in 1996 when former Prime Minister Jean Chrétien signed a deal to sell nuclear reactors to the People's Republic of China, and we gave them the money to buy our reactors. When the Prime Minister at that time said that engagement with China would help our values rub off on them, I've been concerned ever since that their values have rubbed off on us. We are more secretive now. We have the former government of Stephen Harper signed in secret the Foreign Protection Investment Treaty with the People's Republic of China, which means that we could be being sued right now in secret tribunals about which this parliament knows nothing. I want to ask the Honourable Minister, and by the way, congratulations on the new role as Minister of Global Affairs, if he would undertake to allow a full debate in parliament and a review of how much sovereignty we have lost under the Foreign Protection Investment Treaty with the People's Republic of China, which operates entirely in secret.
The Honourable Minister of Foreign Affairs.
Thank you, and I thank my esteemed colleague for her question. I will answer the point generally by saying that the China of 1996 and even the China of 2016 is not the China of 2021. That is why our policies with respect to China, whether it applies to foreign investment, whether it applies to trade, whether it applies to human rights, is evolving. And as I've said on many occasions, we must coexist with China and in some areas cooperate, but in some areas we will challenge them and in some areas we will compete with them. This is part of our evolving policies with respect to China, and all matters as times change can legitimately be reviewed. Thank you.